This is Brent of the Brookbush Institute, and in this video, we're going to do the cervical distraction test for cervical radiculopathy. I'm going to have my friend Yvette come out. She's going to help me demonstrate. This is a very simple test. However, it is specific as well. The research has shown that this has high specificity, low sensitivity. So keep that in mind. If you get a yes, we have a good indicator for a diagnosis. If you get a no, you actually don't have much. Keep going through your cervical radiculopathy cluster. The test works like this. So if she's having symptoms right now, let's say that she came in, she has, you know, right-sided neck pain, she has some tingling into her fingers, maybe she's getting some other random arm-associated pains, right? So we know that we have these indicators that a nerve is not very happy. What we're going to try to do is open up the foramen. Right? That's kind of what this whole test is based on. And the way we're going to do that is by distracting or creating some traction in her cervical spine. So the way you're going to do that is I actually just took my hand, put this part right underneath her cervical ridge right here, right? So I got good purchase. And then I'm going to take this hand and just lightly place under her chin, right? Just in my case, my hands are kind of big, only a couple of my fingers underneath her chin. If you guys are familiar with like chin cradle grip for mobilizations and manipulations, you could get into that position, right? So if that's comfortable for you, go ahead and do that. And what we're gonna do is, okay, so you were feeling some stuff down here, right? Mm-hmm. You feel that stuff in your fingers?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, let's see if it goes away when I traction your neck, all right?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to pull her to end of range in traction. That's end of arthrokinematic range. Hey, Yvette, how does that feel?
Good.
Feels better?
Better.
Okay. So if that feels better, that's a positive sign for this test. You have a positive cervical distraction test. Right? Now, I'll show you guys the other way. So what I did, hand underneath right here, right, the nuchal line. You guys want to look that up on your anatomy, right? I'll put my fingers underneath like this. And of course, I'm very comfortable with that chin cradled grip from doing like my manipulations and stuff. And I'm just going to pull back until end of arthrokinematic range. Again, now I'm going to go, hey, Yvette, how does that feel?
Better.
The hard part is letting their chin go so that you can actually have them say something. And what I'm doing, guys, is most of my force is in the occiput hand, right? Most of the force I'm generating. And sometimes what I'll do is I'll use my forearm kind of against this part of their face, right? To help provide a little bit more tension as opposed to pulling up real hard on the chin, which can be really uncomfortable. I know it might be counterintuitive to think that force across here would be less irritating, but generally speaking, it is. Now, a positive for this test is symptoms decreased with traction. But let me posit this to you. If you got symptoms with traction, I wouldn't discount that as a sign in your evaluation. I think if you traction and it causes more pain, you still have a chance or a good chance or a good indicator that the cervical spine is involved. I know from personal account, I actually had a couple herniated discs and brachial neuritis at one point. If somebody tractioned me, my symptoms went through the roof, right? So we could maybe take a step back, think about how this test works and go, maybe we should say, since you know nerve roots could get stretched in this a little bit, right? Nerves could get stretched if we pull out. Maybe we should say if there is a change in symptoms, that might be a positive. All right, so traditionally it says if we reduce symptoms, that's a positive. I'm saying think about if there's a change in symptoms, maybe that's a positive for this test. Remember that all you're doing is traction for the cervical spine. And as far as your evaluations in clinic, the only time I actually use this test is part of a cluster. Right? So we want to cluster our tests and get the highest accuracy we can, right? If we're going to stick with our evidence-based approach. If you guys have any questions at all, leave them in the comments box below.